get wonderful and exciting concert. Maybe half of our principal, Dr. William Schein, our associate administrators, teachers, and students, I'm delighted to welcome you to our annual Artfest concert. Now, what you will see in here will be a music of very musical style, and what the students have prepared for you is really a musical treat. Now, we have many students that are playing at almost professional level, and some students who are just beginning. We put them all together, and we have wonderful sounds. I would like to introduce some of the students who participated in January in the All County Music Festival held at the Tiller Center. Now, if I call the names, I would like for you to give them a nice hand because they worked very hard to participate and to reach that level of achievement. It's sponsored by the New York State Music Association called NISMA. The names are Heather Edelman, Michael Bosworth, would you please come to the stage?
To a reception at which you have a Just can't get my boy. three 100s, 199, and many grades in the 90s. Carnival of Venice and its variations is the perfect vehicle to showcase two of our outstanding flutists, Jason Gasworth and Catherine Goldberg. Jason is a student of Florence Nelson, a flute soloist, a vocal soloist, planning to major in government at Harvard, an award winner, athlete, and renowned reporter. Catherine Goldberg is a student of Florence Nelson also, and she enjoys many activities, including the Kilties and music, and she was one of the students that got a 100 at Ms. for the All-State audition. Thank you. Beethoven's last piece that we're doing, second movement finale, second symphony finale. The rest of the selections on the program are from this century, because we feel free to express. It's interesting to look at the history of programming. Music during the Renaissance, all that was programmed was music of the Renaissance. During the Baroque, only Baroque. During classical, mostly classical, Baroque here and there. During the 19th century, only Romantic music was programmed. Maybe a little Bach or Mozart once in a while. But in this point, in this century, we never had an acceptance of contemporary music. For the first half of the century, it was all 19th century music that was being programmed, because the audience just couldn't handle some of the 20th century music. In the 1950s, there was a revival of Baroque music. In the 1960s, a revival of classical music with the beginning of the mostly Mozart series that lived in Santa. In the 70s, there was a revival of Renaissance music and period instrument music. The 20th century is almost over, and still we haven't found an audience for the 20th century. So we feel free to express that we're going to be performing now some 20th century music for you, and we're taking a risk. Albanus, and Shostakovich, and you in this audience are to be commended for absorbing a program of modern music. The sounds that you're about to hear are atonal, dissonant, and at times bombastic. It reflects a lot of what's going on in this century. Dmitri Shostakovich, at age 20, wrote, "Music is a means of unifying broad masses of people, not a lead of masses, perhaps, but certainly an organizing force. It is no longer an end in itself, but a vital weapon in the struggle." In this piece that you're about to hear, the Soviet government of the 1930s ordered Shostakovich to compose a symphony that glorified communism and the Soviet government. Shostakovich, who, like most artists and musicians, believed in a democratic and free society, made fun of the order in secret by disguising "How Dry I Am." How dry I am. One altered note so that it sounded, "How dry I am." And then with a military type of rhythm. Finish it with a few more notes that made it sound more military-like. Slower, twice as slow, and push back that original note. "How dry I am." And now, the finale from Shostakovich, Symphony No. 5. Coos's violin concerto, commission for the 150th anniversary of the New York Philharmonic, performed by Glenn Dicterow and Philharmonic. Bernard Holland from the New York Times reviewed him and reported, "It's not a happy piece. Indeed, listeners are likely to be impressed by Mr. Coos's vivid skills, as they are depressed by his melancholy message. Desperate, ominous, the instrument becomes a dramatic tool. Warlike eruptions overwhelm the dialogue. Darkling pain, confused alarms, ignorant armies. It's not an encouraging prospect." Carol Husa, who is best known for his music for Prague 1968, composed after the Soviets invaded his homeland of Czechoslovakia. He was living in Paris at the time, and this piece expresses deep sadness on the situation in his homeland. In 1990, after the Czechoslovakian government reverted to democracy, Husa was invited back to Prague to conduct the work. Nova Nassim will give us a little bit more background on Dr. Husa. We invited Dr. Husa to our concert because he was in town last week for the Philharmonic premiere, but he regretted that he was unable to come on such short notice, and I asked him last summer. So maybe in the future we'll get Dr. Husa to come to our
thank you.
Alan Bobanis was born 82 years ago in Somerville, Massachusetts. He's been called the most dynamic balance yet struck between East and West. He is of Armenian and Scottish descent. The first strong influences on young Hovhannes were the study of astronomy and music of ancient Armenia. To Hovhannes, oh, by the way, the program says Shostakovich for this. It's wrong. This is the prayer of St. Gregory by Alan Hovhannes. The program says Shostakovich. We did Shostakovich on the first day. But this is not Shostakovich, this is Hovhannes. And the Hovhannes, the ideal music is of the giant melody of the Himalayan mountains, 7th century Armenian religious music, classical music of South India, orchestral music of China and Japan, and the opera oratorios of Handel. We also invited Mr. Hovhannes to our concert, and Jessica Goodson will read the letter that he sent to us. Ben Whitney, student of Patrick Dougherty, will be attending Geneseo as a double major. One of the majors will be music, and the other one, he said he'll decide later. Ben Whitney. I know it's late, folks. It's really ranking much later than I thought, but this is a short movie. We're going to play it faster. I want to thank a number of people as the wind players take this seat. My chairman, Dr. Jim Shepard, for all the support, ideas, and assistance he gave me.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and I'll go all meet in wherever we're meeting.